Good morning, everybody. It's a Rudy. All right. Yeah, what a difference a day makes. All right, we are doing... If you watched the last video, you'll know what I'm talking about. What a difference a day makes. I don't know if you're going to see this the day after or probably the day after that because I have to edit it and this and that, but today is a brew day and I'm brewing at IPA because IPAs make me hoppy. So, I'm probably going to just do the same old thing I always do, kind of keep it short and simple for you and just show you the highlights to it all. Going to do a 10-gallon batch. I take you over there to the brew area, but if you look over there, it is so very bright, and just everything is wet and shiny, and it's bright over there. I can't see what you're seeing. Anyway, it's bright over there, so I can't take you over there, or I would either be backlit or something, you know, blown out with white. Nevertheless, let's get started. It is 8:25, and... I'm going to go ahead and get the strike water started. 10-gallon batch IPA. I will give you the breakdown on what it is here after the sun changes up a little bit or things dry out to where it's not quite so bright over there. Anyway, I'll be back. All right, kids, heating up the old strike water. I guess I'll break down the recipe for you now. Break it down! It is going to be, now this is the American IPA. This is going to be, and this is the same one I've done before. If you watch the other videos, I've probably given you the recipe there, but we'll do it again. Dealing with the wind today, so that's going to be an issue. It's not so bad when I get over to the brew kettle, but that thing is all up in the wind, and so I'll probably have to try to shroud it somehow. Anyway, yeah, it's going, coming and going. We are doing the American IPA. Like I say, it's like a clone of a Stone IPA, Anchor Liberty Ale, Sierra Nevada Celebration, or like the Avery IPA. It has, now I'm going to give you the credentials for the 5 gallons. This is 3.25 domestic special pale, a half a pound of domestic carob pills, a half a pound domestic light crystal, and 0.13 pounds of special B. Salts, whichever water salt brand you use, I guess. It's got the gypsum and the other stuff in there. Anyway, it says put that stuff in there. I'm going to do it in the mash, which will be the same scenario. The way I did my water is a total of, this is twice the amount is what I'm doing. But if you were to do it, you're looking at 14.38 pounds times 1.25 quarts per pound divided by 4 to make gallons, which comes up to 4.5 gallons roughly. So I've got 9 gallons of water in there, and I'm going to get it to the temperature of about 170 to go into the mash tun. That's that. Hey, check out what I did. I kind of made myself like a sight glass. Hopefully you can see what I'm showing you.
Usually it doesn't.
1066 is what we're looking for. And that is supposed to finish up at a 1016, which makes it a 6.56 ABV beer. Not quite sessionable, but not bad, you know, right? I like to brew this one. This is a good beer. Some 10 gallons of that stuff going on. Yeah, I'm kind of, the last night, I pulled the old handle on the kegerator and it did the... shit, not again. So I still get another couple gallons in the fermenter because I, you know, I make a little more than what I should maybe. Yeah, so I need to move that into the keg and get her carbonated to where there's some beer to drink. So that's what we're doing and that's how we're going about it. I'm going to get it mashed in. There's really nothing to see from there. I'm just going to attach the hose from that to the outlet of the mash tun. It's over there. With some new stickers on it, I might add. And we'll talk about those later, I guess, if I remember. Anyway, see you in a bit.
Okay. I don't know if y'all can see that or not. It's about 170. Or, let's see, almost 78? 76 degrees Celsius. And so I got this opened up. It slingshots around the back of this thing, through a valve in the back, and into here, underletting. The powdery stuff is the water salts, and the grain stuff is, well, the grains. So I'm underletting now, and no adjuncts in this one, boys. No adjuncts. No rice, no corns. All right, see you in about an hour and a half. All right, I can always tell when it's about to be time to go stirring is when the temperature starts plummeting. Why? Well, the water level's lower than the thermometer, so we know we're almost ready. And so we'll take a peek in here. I've actually snuck in there and started a little bit already. I should have showed you. It was so exciting. So anyway, steamy, getting closer, and I gotta give it the super stir. And like I said, you can see it's dropping down quickly. And so, like I said, it's underneath the thermometer, and so I know we're almost done.
Ooh-wee, this thing's fighting me today. It's moving awfully slow. Totally I'd mention the stickers. This one come from PWPA. It's one of my subscribers. Plays with Volkswagens. Pretty easy to figure out. He sent me that one there. I showed y'all on the other video, I believe. So I got that one installed, and this one here, I like it. Powered by bratwurst and beer. How cool is that? Yeah, it's fighting me a little bit. I got it up to 160 so far, and just waiting on it, to be honest. I think I mashed in a little cool, so I've been recirculating a little bit. Oh, you're recirculating. Check this out. Well, let me just put it this way. I got a little coffee pot thing that's pretty accurate with a digital scale or with a digital gauge on it. And so I've been trying to get the numbers up with that. So I've been doing my Verloff and warming it up, putting it back in the mash tun. There's another sticker for you. Dope. That's a cool looking one there, huh? Awesome stickers. They seem very high quality. They are a pain in the ass to install. But it looks like it's going to be there forever, ever. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So anyway, this is the color of the beer. Hopefully you can see it. Yep, it looks like it's going to be pretty good. Looks like an IPA already. And then over here, to show off a couple more stickers. Mudnut 59 got on there. And there's another one on the other side, if I'm not mistaken. There is. And then also V-Dub sent these guys here. In white. And I'm not sure what that thing's about there, but it means something to somebody, I guess. Again, stickers are really, really nice quality, but they are a pain to install. That one I cut in half because it was all like one, and I guess I didn't get it quite straight. That's okay. All right, so we got empty vessel. About to drop the cord in there, drop the hose in there, and start moving it through. So I'll set up my sparge to rinse the grains from there, and we'll get our brew on, baby. Get our brew on. Thanks again, B-Dub, for the cool stickers. I like that one. I heard about bratwurst and beer. Why am I shaking? Maybe I could use a beer. Hey, the sun's come and gone and coming back again. See how it goes. Righty then. Okay, this is a sparge. What we're doing here is we're
trying to do anyway is have this valve opened over here to kind of match what you've got going out. So you can see how little is going in there. Like I can tune you out some roar. Anyway, so you see how little is coming out of there. That same amount is what's going into the brew kettle through the little tuber right there into the brew kettle. So it's been working on it for a minute. This should take about 45 minutes or more. You know, the longer the better. You're trying to slowly sparge it, slowly work hotter water through, which our temperature now is about 182, 183. You know, it doesn't have to be exact, but it needs to be pretty close. Anywhere from about 180 to 190 is probably pretty good. But so the goal is to keep about an inch of water above the grains. Hopefully I can show you without it fogging up. So that's what we're doing there. Move the viewfinder, make get you further away from it, maybe. I just got some PVC in there. It's kind of generic, but you know, it works. And just you know, just got to push it back and forth to try to cover the grains, get them all heated up. And that's where we're at. And if we get what we need out of it, we'll start our hour boil, and then we'll be dropping the hops in there and this and that. You know. This is the best I've got so far. still working on some ideas, but well, you know. Redneck brewing after all, right? All right, a little update. Things are going well. We won't talk about how long this is taking today. For some reason, this is going extremely slow. But where we're at now is this kettle is close to empty. That's the HLT. And I changed up the sparge thing a little bit. Because see, the way it goes is I don't have any pumps, so everything has to be gravity fed. So I used to keep it the way you've seen it while ago. But you know, after thinking about it, as long as you're not what they call channeling, in other words, you're running the water so quick in that it's going through straight to the outbound, if that makes any sense to you, I decided just to turn those little holes to the upright position, and I just laid that thing right on the bed of grains. I'll show you what I got going, and we'll go from there. Let me grab the camera up and spin the viewfinder thing around, and we'll look at it. Okay, so again, I can tell when the water level gets below this because it plummets. So that's generally the time that I'll open this valve entirely. And I just changed it up, and I think I'm going to do it this way each time and not use those other ones going from side to side. I just turn the holes upright. So if they're upright, it shouldn't be able to channel now, huh? All right, so that's what we got going. I got my inch of water above there. We're almost out of water in the HLT. Again, that's why I have that valve totally open, because there's not much fall between here and here. So I mean, it's not bad when you're first doing it, but the further along you get with it and the lower the water level gets, the less it wants to pull out of there. Okay, our wort's getting a little bit thinner, if you can see any kind of color to that. And the brew kettle is looking like this. So we got a little bit more to go, maybe another couple of inches. And see, that's where I start stirring this thing up and kind of guesstimating what the gravity should be. Remember, we're supposed to be a 1066. So even if I go a little less than that, by boiling it down, I'll get my 1066. So what I'll do is I'll keep checking the wort coming out of here, until it's any less than 1010, or I get my volume, whichever comes first, that's where I'll stay. So I've got several different carboys to be able to ferment this stuff in. So yeah, a little bit more, and I'll start the boil. So that's where we're at. Yeah, it's taking a little bit longer than expected for some reason, I'm not sure. But yeah, it's looking good. I think it's gonna be a wonderful beer when it's all said and done. For some reason, it's taking a while today. I'm not sure. I'm sparging really slowly, I'm sparging really slowly just to be sure to get everything out of the grains. Sorry about that. And so that's where we're at. So, camera, turn it around. All right. So it shouldn't be much longer, and we'll be to the boil, and I will set the tripod up behind it, kind of like I did last time, so we all can get a look in the kettle. And that's where it goes. And so I figured it's about time to start a little drink of her. Like I said, the keg went, so I don't have any more beer during the look. But I got the sheep vodka, and I found a soda pop. So I'm having a double shot. Yeah, double shot of
of vodka in my Coca-Lala, my Coca-Cola, baby. All right. No, I don't get paid by Coke, by the way. Anyway, the sun has burned off some of the clouds, so it's starting to be a beautiful day out here. I think it's like 72 or 3 or something. And so, yeah, and I was about to put on a little jacket, but then the sun come out and burn off some of those clouds. Anyways, back to the business. It's going to be a long video, and it's 4 minutes right there almost. All right. Okay, boys, looking good so far. This was just maybe a couple minutes after I just spoke to you there. Got the refractometer, and we're going to still got the mash tun right here, and we're going to see what's left in there. I've already got my volume. I'm still at a 10.16, but like I said, I got my volume, so I'm hoping all went well, because usually it's a little bit different than that. Usually I'm kind of pushing to reach that volume. Pardon for being reaching around you like that there. All right, so here's my volume right here. Shaboyam. I don't need any more than that. I can't take any more than that. That's plenty enough right there. And so, yeah, we're going to start the boil. Got the hose out, obviously. Oh, looking at the wrong thing. Anyway, I got the hose out, obviously, because I just poured some on the refractometer. And, yeah, all is well. We got the volume, and we were at, give me a second, I guess I can do this live. I don't usually do many things live for y'all, do I? Alright, so let's do a wipe down right there, give this wort a good stir. Everything is sticky right now. The joys of homebrewing. Okay, so yeah, there's probably close to about 14 and a half gallons of wort in there so far. It smells awesome. It smelled awesome even when I first started. It smelled awesome. Alright, it says a few drips on there. Wait for it to cool off just a second. Refractometers are awesome if you get into this business, or not business, if you get into this hobby, you want a refractometer. 3 drops, how long can they stay hot? You know, you're not having to get a whole test jar, the you know what I'm talking about, the test jar. Don't have to have a whole one of those to do a little sample. Oh, I dribbled it on there, but I guess I got most of it off. Right, give another little something. 3 little drops, they just have to be across that glass smoothly. And we are at it says 10.55, but that's okay. That's okay, don't fear, we're gonna boil it down. 10.66, maybe I went a little too thin with it. Maybe I got a little too much volume. But we'll find out at the end of the brew how it turned out. I'd rather have a little more beer that's less potent. You know, maybe that, I mean, so I didn't hit my numbers, and somebody might point their finger and shake it or whatever, but I don't care. It was going to be a 6.something% beer. I'm going to drink them, you know, one after the other anyway, so maybe a little less than 6 will be all right. We'll see. Let's start the boil, see if we can get back to that 10.66 that we worked on first. If nothing else, I'll extend my boil just a little bit. Yeah, it's a 10.56 maybe. Yeah, more like 10.55, no lie. Okay, I'd show you, but I've never been good at that. I've not ever had good luck with it. You gotta trust me, 10.55, we're gonna looking for 11 points on the boil. Might be a 90 minute boil, but it's okay. It's a beautiful day out now. It's not as windy, and it's just, what else am I doing today? I'm brewing beer. Okay, and there's always more cleaning to do. I got the yeast, the dry yeast there. I think I'm gonna do a beer on beer for at least half of it, because I've got the lager. I don't know, I'll figure it out as we go. I've got lots of other carboys, so we'll see how it goes. This could be a long ass video, isn't it? All right. If you hung in this long, thank you so much. Yeah, we'll start to boil. Let's get on with this stuff, man. Let's get it done, boys. Get it done. All right. Kind of forgot how I had you before. I guess I propped you up on the edge of the brew bench or something. I'm not sure. Anyway, this is a very close-up of a hot break. This is going to continue to make this kind of foam stuff here. I wish I could have cut you a little further away. What did I do last time to make all this happen? It must have been something smarter than what I'm doing here. So anyway, this is where you really have to throttle the heat, because this is when all the proteins come to the top of the wort. And yeah, it can be kind of tricky. I don't know if you can hear the audio, me throttling the gas, because like I said, it's going to happen quickly. This is not working for you, is it? All right, let me resituate you or something.
Okay, gang, I think I got you a little better now. Actually, let me lower you down some, get you a little closer to the action. Oh boy, all right.
Danger, danger, careful.
So this is the brew kettle, all right. Yeah, you're a little wobbly jawed, but you get the idea. It's round, so which way is up anyway? All right, so right now I am throttling the fuel. And I've got some star sand here on the other in the other hand to be able to make sure that we don't have a boil over. This stuff on top is all the proteins, and so we just need to get it through this initial part of the boiling, the beginning of the boiling, this hot break, so they call it. And so yeah, you probably just stir and throttle that gas, you know, just try to get some of these proteins mixed back in. Some people actually take these off. Sorry if the wind is noisy. And you're probably gonna see me pull out at least one leaf or whatever these things are that the pine trees put out. Little caterpillar looking things. Anyway, so this is probably the most challenging part, I guess, in that, especially with a kettle this darn full, is just waiting for it to boil over. But once you make it past this part, then you're good to go. So I'll probably leave you there where you're at right now, and that way I don't have to change the camera angle again. Thinking out loud, aren't I? Blah, blah, blah. All right, so let's get through the hot break, and then we'll start the timer for 5 minutes to drop the first hops. I have a hop spider, which is nothing more than a cylindrical filter thing, but there's going to be so many hops in here that I don't think it's going to do that well. I think it's just going to be too many hops, so I'm just going to look for a hop bag, which is kind of like a pantyhose, pretty much, you know, or a muslin bag. And if I can't find that, I'm just chunking them in. I don't care. It's all good. It's just beer, right? It's just beer. It's going to be a wonderful IPA, but it's going to have a lot of hops. So let's make it through the hop break real quick. I'm going to turn off the camera, because I know y'all don't want to watch this for a long time. I guess I can edit some of this out of it. It's too awfully loud. That's about 14 gallons worth of beer right there. So the thing is, you gotta be paying attention here. See how it goes. There's a star sand that I'm squirting on it, which is, it won't hurt it a bit. Flavorless. It probably could be water even. It really, at this point, doesn't make a difference. This is all in the hot side of brewing. So it's gonna get sanitized either way. Thing is, my regulator likes to kind of gets hung up there sometimes. All right, so just make it through here, and after we make it through this little hot break, you can turn your back on it, then you don't have to worry about it. Looks like we might be getting closer. I'll tell you what, if you turn your back at all right now, it will boil over. Period. You know, they say a watch kettle never boils. It's just the opposite. You turn your back, and it's gonna boil over. Period. Just the way it goes. I don't care how big of a batch, or even if you're doing the goo or the powder beer, the dry malt extract, either way, it's gonna have this hot break. Like I said, once you get it past this hot break, as long as you don't throttle it up too much, you're good to go. That's a good rolling boil there. That'll get the business done. And let me squirt out this foam here a little bit. See if we might even be done at this point. There's gonna be a little up there, but bottle it up, see if it's going to get crazy. See how it goes? And blam, it's back, right? Who says I don't like hot beer? All beer was hot at least once. Give it up for a second. Sure, easy, killer. Alright, so I kind of tease it a little bit. I'll throw the hella heat to it just for a second, just to make sure I can turn my back on it. Looks like that might have been just that easy. Sometimes it's not so easy. You might fight that thing for 10 minutes sometimes. Kind of like fishing, I guess. Trying to reel in that big one. Okay, looks like we've done it. And I'll probably do the hop spider maybe for the first couple or something, but this is such a big beer that there's so many hops in here anyway that I don't want to put all the hops in there. So I'll put the first ones in the hop spider deal, and then the rest I'll see if I can find the muslin bag. It
looks like that's it. Okay, I'll catch y'all in a few more minutes. That was 5 minutes of me, blah, 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 huh? All right. All right, gents. Oh, yes, you're getting a view of the false bottom that was passed to me once upon a time. Anyway, we got the Willamette. No, we don't. We have Warrior. The Warrior are alpha acids of 16.8%. It says bright, ripe fruit, honeysuckle, sweet herbs, and greenwood. Made in the USA, baby!
Yay, yay!
So that's it. Got two. Now remember, the 10-gallon batch. So two of these in the hop basket or the hop spider or whatever you want to call it. That's where all the smell changes ways and gets more and more yummy. So I got both those open, and then we're going to have two doses of Willamette, like I'd mentioned earlier. They're like little hot pellets. They're smaller than usual. Anyway, as long as they work, they work. So, yeah, I'll see you in 40 minutes. Yeah, 40 minutes. Yeah, 40 minutes. Stir them on in a little bit. And when you're doing this, you might want to watch for boilover, because sometimes they can cause trouble, too. Again, I'm not crazy about this whole hop spider thing. I don't really think it helps that much. And when you get a bunch of them in there, it gets to where I don't feel like they're getting wet like they could. So sometimes I baste them. All right. Anyway, see you in 40 minutes because there's nothing here to see. All right. Oh, glass is fogged up. All right. See you in a bit. All right, gentlemen and ladies and children of all ages. All right. So. The next hop drop is going to be 2 whole ounces. Again, 10-gallon batch. Y'all know. Willamette. This is floral, incense, and elderberry. This is a 5.9 alpha acids. Again, I say 2 ounces.
10-gallon batch.
Okay, so we're getting closer, kids. I guess all the hot pellets are getting smaller. Yeah. Looked more like rabbit food before. Oh, y'all can't see that. It's so shiny. Anyway, I don't know why they're so small now. They used to be like a bit bigger. Not that it makes any difference. But, be the scenario. Here we go. And in the pool they go. I'm going to keep doing it this way. It looks like they're dissolving more so than I thought. Which then I wonder why do we have this hop spider if they just make it through the little the mesh. I don't know how many microns they are or something. I'm not real versed on that part. But for some reason, they seem to be making it through now. Where before, they just kind of, I don't know, they just kind of filled it up. So if these will do the same way, I'll continue to just keep dropping them in there. Wee! All right. And we should be good for another, 15 minutes or so? We're getting closer. I cranked up the heat a bit and checked the refractometer. The refractometer, and refractometer said it is a 1063, maybe a 4, 1064. So we're getting there. I might boil it just a little bit longer than the 60 minutes just to get it at that 1066. Oh, if I didn't explain it before, these numbers I'm saying, those are the amount of sugar that's in the solution. The more sugar, the more alcohol by volume, and the bigger the beer, as it be. So, I don't want to brew too much, boil it too much longer than I have to, because then it throws off all your bittering and this and that for the hop. So I'm going to try to hit it right on the money. If I get to a 1065 or so, you know, if I'm close, I'm good. Anyway, I'll see y'all in another 15 minutes where I will, I'll probably have to move the camera one more time and pop in the wort chiller to be able to get this stuff cooled down. We haven't lost much volume, but I have picked up some original gravity, so if you know what I'm talking about, then you'll understand things are going well. If not, I'm trying to explain it as best I can. Anyway, I'll see you in about 15 minutes. All right, gang, we are getting closer. All right, so, I've got the wort chiller in there. Y'all notice you never ever seen my wort chiller going in there, like, Y'all trust me, right? Y'all trust me? Y'all want some of my beer? You know all my brew stuff's outside, right? Anyway, so it's the last hop drop for this one here. Until it's done, there is a dry hop of the Zytos, which is going to be another 2 ounces, but that'll be after the first few days anyway. Let's get it making beer, you know. It'll still work right now, but let it make beer, and then we'll drop those dry hops in there, which I don't know why they call it dry hop, but anyway, they were all dry. So this next one here is Willamette, just like the last. I don't know if you can see it through the camera, but it says 5.98 alpha acids. Have I mentioned I've had 3 soda pops and about 8 shots of cheap vodka? Anyway, so work chiller's in, flame is out, that's why it's not noisy, and I'm going to pop these guys in there. You know, these are going to go straight into there. I'm not going to use the hop spider thing. These are going straight into it because, by the time it's all said and done, they're all going to go to the bottom anyway. But I want all the aroma, and that's the last ones that go in, are the aroma and flavor. Go by and see DJ's Brew Tube. Aroma! Yay, yay! Okay, so these are going straight into the thing. I will, let me show you what it looks like in there real quick. If you've never seen something like this, let me catch up. Oh, I got a cord on you and stuff too. All right, yeah. Give me a second. Give me just a second. You're unplug you because you were starting to run dead a little bit. Look at the way this looks in here. That's what beer looks like when it's, been cool to, oh, come on now. Come on now. See how that stuff just like moves in there? Isn't that crazy? So anyway, y'all know what the work chiller is about. Cold water goes in through the coil and it's gonna dissipate the heat and cool off the beer, and hot water comes out the other side. Something very important to note is have both of these hooked up before you start. If you don't, whatever water is left in that coil is going to come out of one end or the other, and you don't want that to happen. So be sure that both your inbound and outbound to your work chiller, y'all have seen that thing before, it's just a coil of copper wire, or copper tubing, soft copper. And so anyway, it's very important that both those be hooked up. All I'm gonna do, and I'll do it right here in front of you, is These pellets are smaller, aren't they? Look how small those things are. They're not the same size as the others. These are going straight in. And I've only got one hand, so I'm going to do the other one the same way. I'm going to stir it up real good and just let them kind of dissolve in there. See how they're doing? And then I will be back after I've got you cooled off. And it's going to take a while, and I've already found what containers the wort's going to go into. Let me put you back on the stand. And I will get a original gravity reading before I get it into the vessels, and then so we'll know kind of where we stand. Oh, y'all are whoppy judd. Sorry, guys. I'll try it. All right. So, got refractometer. We'll give it a good stir. Oh, yeah, y'all can't see, huh? I got a long, like, selfie stick kind of thing that goes on my tripod. My kid calls it something different, but we won't call it that. Anyway. So here we go, got a few drops on the refractometer. It's actually called a refractometer. And remember, we were supposed to be at the 6.6. We are at, can't see with the glasses on. See, I don't know, used to the line was more vivid. If you've never seen one of these things, it's actually blue on the top and white on the bottom. It looks like, I'll have my wife look at it too, but because it's a little blurry. Used to it was like a pretty defined line. It looks like it's a 6.5. It might even be a 6.6. I'll have the wifey look at it also. I can't see you. I'll have the wifey look at it also and see what she thinks, but I think I might have got pretty darn close. And the whole volume is, I showed you in there just a second ago. So probably just guesstimating about 13 gallons, you know, so. Did well, you know. Had I just had the 10 gallons that I was going to put in the fermenters, they would have been way higher. I don't know. Looks like everything went well. It does take a little bit for this to cool off, but I will have my wife look at it. It kindly looks like the 6.5, might even be the 6.6. So I think I hit my numbers. I'll try to show you. It ain't gonna work, but I'll try to show you. I've seen the other guys do this stuff. Anyway, you gotta trust me here. Got freaking dander or something on there. Anyway, I got a little buzz on. It's about time to get these suckers, get this shit in the fermenters and call it a day. Everything's worked out so far so good. Had kind of a rough start. It's been a long day, actually, longer than normal. The flame just didn't want to blow for me today. I don't know. It's quite windy, so that didn't help out a bit.
If I had Brian's system or any electric brew system, it wouldn't have made a darn bit of difference. It could have been a hurricane out here, and those suckers would have still put out all the energy. Nevertheless, okay. Next clip will be me putting these baby, putting this in actually several carboys. I think I'm gonna do a 5 and 2 3s or something. I don't know. I've got glass in there. I don't want to have to get back into the plastic again, but if I do, I do. I mean, I can put it in the bucket still, just the same. All right, I know this has been a long video so far. Again, I said before, if you're still here, salute to you. You get extra points. They're like the Drew Carey points. They don't make a difference. But, okay, give me a second. Let me get this cooled down. 45 minutes. Not really that long. Maybe. I want a wort chiller. So, everybody get their monies together and send me a wort chiller, a plate chiller. Ask Brian Fisher where to get it. Fresh metal on brew. Ask him where to get one. That dude, he got it really cheap. Rotten dog. Anyway, I'll be back. Okie dokie. Somehow I didn't realize it was going to be like that when I looked over the edge. Right. Anyway, done deal. I got this little vessel here filled up as much as I need to anyway. I might have to top it off a little bit more. One over yonder way, past the star sand. And I'm working on getting a big one filled up as we speak. I missed my numbers a bit. I got a 1060. Ooh, what was it? Damn it. I mean, don't say bad words. 1063. Let's get one more peek at it. I missed it by just a smidgen. The weird thing is, it showed that I was way over a while ago, and I guess the temperature has a lot to do with it, but you think, how, you know, it's 4 drops on this thing. How bad could it be? Okay, I am at a 1063, so I missed it by 0.03 marks, so that's not awfully bad. I don't know. It's all right. I ain't complaining. It's all good. I don't know what happened. Like I said, my mash was a little cool to begin with. That might have something to do with it. Again, I'm not complaining. It's all good. It's going to make for beer, and I'm trying to stay out of that light like it was just doing. But still keep an eye on this thing to where it doesn't overflow. Oh, and I'm kind of topsy-turvy, aren't I? All right. Anyway, I guess that completes the day. This has been the American IPA, and got probably closer to 13 or 14 gallons of it. So, there's going to be a lot, and it's probably what happened right there. Had I just stopped at the 10-gallon mark, I'd probably been right on the money, but yeah, I just stretched it out a bit more. So there's going to be more to drink and a little less strong, and that's not hurting old Drunkinone whatsoever, because that's probably just as well. Guess that's it then. Another happy brew day. This will probably be out on Wednesday. It's Monday right now. But this will probably be out on Wednesday. That'll give me time enough to do the edits tomorrow. And it takes almost a whole day to upload things to the internet because my internet is really, really slow. So anyways, thanks for coming by. I sure appreciate y'all. This has got to be a long video by now. I don't know how long it's going to be because there's a bunch of little pieces to it. And this little bit right here is already 2 minutes and 15 seconds. And you know I'm going to babble a bit more before I get out of here. So, really, that's it. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. May the force be with you. All that wonderful stuff. Thank you so much if you've made it, especially this far through the video. Because, there's many other videos to watch and probably a lot more interesting. But, anyway, we had a debris day. And we made an IPA, because IPA is my green hopper. All right, guys. Y'all take care. Love, peace, monkey vibes. See y'all on the next one. Cheers and adios from the drunken one. Yeah, adios. I'm guessing if I wasn't so greedy, I would have probably had my numbers right. Anyway, can you say no airlocks and go straight to blow-off tubes? I didn't leave enough airspace in there, did I? Enough headspace. Yikes, this ought to be interesting. All right, I can hear some bubbling in my life. Cheers, guys. Thanks for coming by.